So welcome to our first webinar at NPTech Projects and the WP for Good Club. We're very grateful that you're all here and that you're able to join us today and dive into what's new in WordPress 4.7, which was released a week ago, almost to the hour. And my name is Birgit Polly Haag, and I'm one of the founders of NPTech Projects. Another founder is Jim O'Reilly, who is also with us today. He'll keep an eye on the chat window and might answer to your comments too, because when I'm going through the slideshow, I don't see the chat window. The slideshow is available online right now. Here's the link for it, and I'm also gonna add it to the chat window. My PowerPoint slides are definitely like children. I like them. I find them beautiful, but you might not think about that. So before we start, however, on the WordPress, let me tell you a little bit about NPTech Projects. NPTech Projects is a 501c3 organization and was founded in 2015 by a group of technology strategists and practitioners who see a great need to raise the digital literacy in nonprofit leadership and communication. In helping nonprofits with their website, we also want to improve nonprofit communication, proficiency in online fundraising, and collaboration with online ambassadors carrying the cause further into the world. We have two programs that we run right now. One is the WP for Good Club, and the other one are Impact Circles. The WP for Good Club members benefits is a subscription to nonprofit technology news around WordPress. It also provides what we call peace of mind hosting and server administration for the website. That comes out of a problem that we found repeatedly, that every time a nonprofit changed the web hosting or web developer, they had to revamp the whole thing. And it was never a stable platform. In addition to that, we also provide email support, office hours, and training material to content producers like you and advise in all things WordPress, as well as tangential topics like social media integration, CRM integration, and online payment systems. The second program is Impact Circles. It's a monthly roundtable for executive directors as a peer-to-peer group to discuss strategy and operations and how technology can help with process optimization, knowledge transfer, and measuring programs. During our pilot season last spring and summer, we received great feedback and tremendous encouragement to make it a permanent program. Right now, we are fundraising for scholarships to give to 20 executive directors of smaller and or new organizations who might not be able to afford participation otherwise, or cannot convince the board that it's right now a necessity. Jim O'Reilly, you see him in the chat window, is also one of the founders of NPTech Project, but he's also the facilitator of Impact Circles. He and I, we talked in more detail in our 9th episode of our NPTech Project podcast about it. Listen in and learn more. And of course, we hope that you too will support nonprofit executive directors and donate to our scholarship fund. But now, without further ado, let's start with the main topic. WordPress 4.7 is called Vaughn. For those of you who haven't seen the release video, let's watch it together.
WordPress 4.7 Vaughn, named after jazz legend Sarah Sassy Vaughn, makes it easier than ever to set up your website the way you want it. Meet Carly. Carly operates a pet store and needs a website. Carly looks at her options and discovers WordPress. With WordPress, Carly can choose from thousands of free themes to fit her needs. Carly's decided on 2017, a brand new theme for WordPress built from the ground up for businesses. 2017 includes a sleek design with large images throughout, perfect for both small businesses like a pet store and larger businesses. Because this is a brand new site, 2017 will show some starter content to help Carly visualize how it can work for her store and get started with customizing it to fit. New visual edit shortcuts show what aspects of her site can be changed right there within the live preview. As she customizes her theme, Carly notices that she can add a video to her header. She chooses a video she shot of her niece with a puppy and adds the video header to her site directly from her tablet. Because you can create pages while editing menus in the customizer in WordPress 4.7, Carly can continue building her site structure without breaking her current workflow. Carly wants to make one more change before she's ready to share her site. Make the name of her store more noticeable. The new CSS panel makes this easy and shows your changes live as you build. And with that, she publishes the brand new website for her pet store. Carly's happy. WordPress 4.7 includes all of these features and more, along with exciting developer features like REST API content endpoints. WordPress 4.7 Vaughn, helping you set up your site the way you want it.
So, what do you think about the video? What's the most appealing feature you heard about in this video? Well, add your comment to the chat room. So, what's new for content creators? The video actually only covered a fraction of the new things available. The list of changes in 4.7 is huge, and some of it is really exciting. Today, we only cover the parts that are interesting for you as content creators. The video mentioned the REST API. That's certainly something not for content creators. That's for developers. That's for designers as well. So. Oh, sorry that you was hard to hear. I'll put the video where you can see this into the resources. It's in the resource part of it, so you can review it again. Once your site has updated to 4.7, you can also see the video in your own environment. So we have a new theme, 2017. Yeah, the naming is always quite creative here. We have a new theme. It's targeting small businesses much more than any other of the default themes did. And you saw most of it already in the video. We will talk about the customizer's changes. And then we have some editor changes and the enhanced PDF support in the media library. So the theme 2017 has a video header, a multi-part front page, and starter content. The starter content only comes into play when it's actually a brand new site. For sites that are already existing, it just migrates your content into the site. It was created by over 100 contributors. And the lead developer is Mel Joyce, a user interface designer from Boston. And I can show you how the video header. We have our beta website here where we test WordPress. Just before it went live, we did a few changes here. And I would like to show you how to put the video header into that. You can either upload a video, but lo and behold, you can also use a YouTube URL, because uploading video might be a little bit tricky, and I'll show you what happened to me when I first tried it. This is a little video from that. So I went in, grabbed a video that I wanted to put in there, and I got an error message, and that said pretty much, wait for it, said, oh, it exceeds the maximum upload size for the site. You might have seen this before. And of course, videos have a much higher footprint than any other medium that you're going to upload there. So I'm going to show you how to use it with a YouTube video. So to access the customizer, you go to your front page, make sure you're logged in, but go to your one of the pages on your website and then click on the customize that's on top on the black toolbar up there. You can all see the screen. And then it opens the website again, but with a left side pane. And some of you might already see some of the changes that happened with that, but I will reference it a little later. So I go to header media, and the select video and upload the video was where I failed before, but now I have a nice YouTube URL that you can grab from the YouTube website. And I just tab out of it, and another good place, and that's the video that I selected. It pulls it from YouTube, shows it in my preview, and I can then decide if I want to save and publish it or not. So I save and publish, and then it changed over from that original big image to a video. So next in the customizer, we've seen how the preview kind of works, but then there are also shortcuts for edit. When I go into customize again, and you saw them already, there are these blue circles with the pencil in it. The customizer is actually something that has been in WordPress since the version 3.4, so that's about 3 years ago, or even 4 years ago. I was very resistant in using it because it took a while to actually be all that you can use it for all things that you wanted to do. So, so there are these blue dots where you can then say, okay, I want to change the headline on my website, I click, but I don't know exactly where it's going to be on the customizer. There was a which pane it was, so that was quite a contention. Now you can just click on the blue circle next to the item and change it. And you see how everything, including my typos, come with it in the preview pane. And then I can say, okay, I also want to change my menu, edit the menu, and I can then add another item right here in my in the customizer. So I have another page that hasn't been linked yet, that is called Tech Tools. And I don't want that to be, I want it there, but I don't want so many items in my navigation bar. So I'm taking the test in WordPress and make it a submenu item on my site. And I can then save and publish and then see it right here. It already has changed in the preview, but now it kind of, it's a little tricky. Went back to the previous version, but if I reload the page, it kind of shows it. So that's a little interface problem. So when I scroll up, I see. The same with the widget area. See on the blue cycles, you never know what the widgets areas are, and I forgot the name and I have to look for it. So here's a WordPress, the widget area I want to change because the address is wrong or the title is wrong. I can then change the information that's published there. And the little circle that shows it that it's saved already, and I can go back. So that. Or change another widget. So that's quite nice. If I wanted to add another widget, and that was the moment where I changed over to the customizer from the admin section, because the admin section, when I was scrolling all the different widgets all the way down the page, I was not able to drag them over to the other interface. So now I just kind of knew, I just check it. It will automatically be put in the widget section. I can just change the order of it and give it a title. Wanted to and only show three posts from that. And then I save and publish it. And that's my customizer. So that's the customizer. There are certainly, you can always explore that. I also put in the slideshow a little video so you can kind of see more about the demonstration of the shortcuts. But the next thing is that's even more prominent than you're not changing your website all that often, but what you use every day or multiple times a day is the editor. And the editor toolbar has changed. In this slide, I put in, for comparison's sake, the new toolbar on top and the old one on the bottom, and I marked with green and red dots the modifications. The biggest changes that this drop-down box for headings and paragraphs is from the second row into the top row, so everybody, any content creator sees that. It's very important to put subheaders in your text and format them correctly. So the header drop-down is there. To make room for it, the horizontal line button and the strike-through formatting button moved into the second row. Then two buttons were removed. That's the underline and the justified that were on the old bar. Most users, so underlining text for emphasis has gotten a little bit out of mold because most users get confused with it. They associate underlined text now with links. 15 years of training on the internet kind of does that to you. And then they are confused when they try to click on it and nothing happens. So if for emphasis now, it's definitely bold or italics. Or use one of the heading 1, 2, 4, or 5, or 6 to emphasize your text, not underlining. The second button is justified, the justified formatting button, which has never really worked well in HTML on a website, but now with fluid screen sizes, like you're going from a big screen to a small screen to an even smaller screen, it has really lost its value for a formatting. Text in a readable fashion. So that's the change in your day-to-day work. What also happened on the editor is that you now can see the shortcuts. WordPress actually has quite a few keyboard shortcuts that are but they are now listed in the editor, so you don't have to remember them. And if you don't have to remember them, you might as well kind of learn how to use them, because changing between the keyboard and the mouse always is a little bit of a disruption. If you can do it a little bit more fluently, you might appreciate it. So you can do the heading is, and it's a little bit different for Windows than for Macs. Shift-Alt-1 is for heading 1, Shift-Alt-2, there you get the picture. For a paragraph, like no subheader at all, it's all Shift plus 7. That's for Windows. In Mac, it's Control and the Options key with the right numbers on it. But when you hover over the keyboards on the buttons on the toolbar, you will see I'll also learn about the other shortcuts for any other formatting. So that's certainly a good thing. And then I think it's last but not least is the main change on PDF documents in the media library. The old way is you upload a PDF to the library and you see this gray square with a more or less intriguing file name. And the new way is that you now see, when you go into the library, a preview of the first page as an image of your PDF. So you know a little bit better what kind of documents you are linking with the other, with your content. There is a slight caveat to it. In order to generate the previews, the web hosting server needs to support two libraries and a module. And it might be that you, even if you update to the newest version 4.7 on your site, you might not see the preview of the PDF images, basically either because your hosting company runs an older version of PHP, which is a programming application server, or some of the image libraries are not supported. So if you find this, you might need to talk to them to either update the PHP version and update the libraries. We had this on our server as well. We contacted our techies, and it was within a few minutes, it was kind of updated. But we have our own environment, so it's a little bit easier to tackle that. So I think that's it. We are 25 minutes into the webinar. We have and I have a list of resources for you. There's a WordPress 4.7 release announcement, which gives you the video, so you can kind of revisit that again, and also some summaries there. Then there is the WordPress 4.7 field guide. I think it gets a little bit, and then the new theme place where you can kind of take a look at it again. The field guide, is really all the changes and the communication that the contributors, there were 475 contributors for 4.7, kind of had all the discussions. So it also goes really into the weeds of the development and how to make customizer features available in themes for the theme developer. And so, and then if you need support, there is, of course, on WordPress.org, the whole support site. But there is a master list of things. If it doesn't work or broke your site, first rule of engagement is don't panic. But it also has a list of what you could do to troubleshoot it, and what is actually not a bug, even if you can't see it. And one of them is the PDF previews. It spells out the libraries that need to be available. Also says that the customizer features need to be built into the theme same with the video headers. So that's our resource list. And this pretty much covers what I wanted to cover in terms of what's new in WordPress 4.7 for content creators. And I'm ready for your question. So, and I'm now also looking at the chat window. I have a question from Sandy. Yeah, I love the video, Margo. So let's go to the questions. Sandy, since the underline will be removed from the toolbar, when I add a link within text, will that link automatically be underlined in my post? Yes, if the theme has set up the link, it's a theme thing or style sheet. Formatting, normally those links are, nobody really changes the style sheet. But if it is not underlined or in a different color, it might not be underlined, but it might be in a different color on the front end, then you definitely need to talk with the developer. Unless you want to try your luck in writing your own CSS. So any other questions about WordPress, about websites, about, well, social media, if you want to. So, 1, 2, and the poll today, 1, 2, 3, 4. So at, a little bit over half access the WordPress site multiple times a month. And then we have the one power user who accesses it multiple times a day. And then also power users, but not as often or as needed, a couple of times a week. So that's pretty cool. We have another question. Margo, a rookie question, a few things. I have been bad about updating my WordPress site, and it's on 4.4.2. Do I have to take immediate steps before going to 4.7? Well, let me answer this with another question. Have you updated your plugins in between when it came up to updating? You also get a notification that there are updates for plugins. Did you also not update those, or are those up to date? Yeah, I presume the power user, that's you, definitely, yes. So if the plugins are not updated, I would say deactivate all the plugins. Or, well, it's going to be a tough, could be a little tough because I don't know your website. 4.4 was about a year and a half ago. So there were quite several security updates that were done. Yeah, Amago, I think you need to be a little careful. The best way to do this would be to make a copy of your website into a staging site, update it and see what breaks. So you're not taking down your live website. But not all. Now, and Margo, do you use a custom theme, or is it a theme out of the box? Okay, yeah. Yeah, the staging, although I'm very confident every time I update it, I'll say, oh, nothing's gonna break. But for some of the websites, I'd rather go the safe route and update, because some of the plugins might not in between be up to date, so it might be a little bit tricky. Any other questions? Any other thoughts? Well, you're all welcome. Thank you very much for joining us. I will send you the link to the recording, as well as a little survey to find out what you thought about it, about this webinar, about the tool that we used, and how it performed. I know exactly about the video. Well, you're all welcome, and hope you have and greetings and happy holidays for everyone in South of Florida, in MD, in Boston, in Maryland, Prasun asked, do you think the changes will be difficult for my editors to adopt to? I think the toolbar changes, they're probably hardly notice them, unless they were really keen on using the underline and the justify. It might be easier for them to understand the heading part, the subheaders part, while they're seeing this. I don't think there's a big change there. Because how it's handled, it's not, yeah. Good. All right. Well, thank you all for joining, and happy WordPressing for everybody. Take care.